My name's Jennifer Long. I'm a laryngologist at UCLA, and I study regenerative medicine for the larynx. So regenerative medicine is harnessing cells to repair or replace tissues or cells that aren't functioning properly. I'm most interested in the larynx. I take care of patients who have laryngeal problems that impacts their speech, their swallowing, and sometimes even their breathing. So we have a lot of treatments that are available for these patients, but sometimes we still reach dead ends. And those areas where our current treatments fall short really then become opportunities for us to envision new treatments that we're studying in the lab. So I do take care of people with voice and swallowing disorders. So I would then envision being able to take some cells that were engineered, for example, in order to help these people and either inject them or implant them directly into the patient. On the medial surface. I don't come from a scientific or a medical family. In fact, my parents didn't have the opportunity to go to college. But I do credit my mom with really getting me started, reading, math games, music, which is almost like a science in itself. I'm from the Midwest. I grew up in Ohio, and then I lived in Minnesota for 8 years, and now I have the opportunity to live in Los Angeles. So I didn't always know that I was interested in science. For a long time, I liked languages, I liked music, but then I took chemistry class in high school, and that was like a whole new world that opened up. I thought it was just amazing that you could control these molecules, predict what happened, and make something new out of it. So that really set me on the path then to pursue science as a career. I think a lot of the motivation comes from when we see patients who have really impacted quality of life that we're not able to help otherwise. So for me, that linkage between my work as a physician and my work as a scientist really come together a lot. Often I will see patients who it's very hard to tell them that we don't have anything more that we can offer them to help their speech or to help their swallowing. So those patients then provide the motivation to go try new things and really advance medicine for everyone. So I think it's a very rewarding way to have a long-lasting impact even beyond those individual patients that I'm taking care of. And we can think about having an impact that goes into all of society. Being in the lab is a lot of fun. It's an outlet for creativity. In a lot of ways, I actually think it's similar to music, because in order to be very good at it, you do have to pay attention to details and often practice things over and over so that you really perfect it. But at the same time, there's a lot of room for exploration so that you can try completely new things that have never been done before and get to spread your wings and be creative. I would be really excited if we could take some cells and help restore voices for some people who otherwise aren't able to communicate as they would like. That's sort of where I would hope that my lab will be in the coming decades. Even if we don't get to that point, I'm really excited just to be part of the scientific community that is working on these cell therapies. Right now, there are cells being used in a lot of other diseases, like heart attacks, wound healing, even wrinkles. And all these things are really exciting. Even though I haven't worked on those projects myself, I still feel connected to them as being part of the field that has been working to advance these therapies. I think a career in science is a great option. It gives you a lot of flexibility.
Yeah.
That flexibility is one of the things that got me interested in a scientific and an engineering field in the first place, because I didn't really know what I wanted to do, but I knew that it would open doors for me. I do think it's important to find your passion and to follow it, because once you have identified something that you love and that motivates you to get up and come to work in the morning, then everything is easy.